Hello and welcome again to the course of mechatronics. This is Mr. M. Azadov from SITCOE, and we will be studying today different types of electronics filters. So objective of today's lecture is to study different types of electronic filters, and outcome is the student will be able to explain different electronic filters. So introduction. Electronic filters remove unwanted frequency components from the applied signal, enhance the wanted ones, or both. This is based on the type. So basically, the work of filter or the term filtering is used to describe the process of removing a certain band of frequencies from a signal and permitting the others to be transmitted. The oldest forms of electronic filters are passive analog linear filters, constructed using only resistors and capacitors, or resistors and inductors. These are known as RC and RL single pole filters respectively. So basically those are very simple filters for removing unwanted signals from coming signal. Unwanted signal can also be called as noise, so we have to remove the noise from the input signal. So next will be the types of filters. Basically filters are classified with different categories. The first category is according to the components used. So active filters and passive filters are the two types based on the components which are used for the making of the filters. So active filters are made up of operational amplifiers, resistors and capacitors, and the passive filters are made up of resistors and inductors or capacitors. Those are called as RC or RL circuits, or RC filters or RL filters. What is the difference between these two? Actually, active, we know that operational amplifiers will be requiring additional power supply for working of them, so those are called as active components, and because of that the filters are called as active filters. So active filters provide additional thing, that is gain also, to the signal. So with the filtering they also provide the gain, voltage gain. That is the main advantage of active filters. But active filters deal with low frequencies only, and they are less suitable for very high frequency applications. So passive filters are used at the high frequency applications, as they are most responsive at higher frequencies. Again, in passive filters, inductors are very rarely used, as they are having negative impact on the performance. And in active filters, inductors are not used because of the constructional constraints. So basically these are two types based on the components used: active filters and passive filters. The next category is according to the working of a filter, or we can say according to the frequency the filter can handle. So there are four types: low pass filters, high pass filters, band pass filters and band stop filters. So actually in signal conditioning introduction we have gone through these details, but just we are having the revision here. So again, graphs of these four filters are also shown on this slide, that is frequency response graphs. Okay, so low pass filters, as the name suggests, it will handle, or it will allow lower frequencies to pass from the signal, input signal, to the output. High pass filters, again they will pass high frequency signals only. Band pass filters, they will pass only certain band of frequencies to output, which is called as a bandwidth of this filter. Then band stop filter, they will only stop certain frequencies from going at the output. So we will now combine these two criteria. So we can say here total 8 different filters can be studied,
एक्टिव लो पास फिल्टर्स, एक्टिव हाई पास फिल्टर्स, एक्टिव बैंड पास फिल्टर्स एंड एक्टिव बैंड स्टॉप फिल्टर्स, दीज फोर टाइप्स। एंड देन पैसिव लो पास फिल्टर्स, पैसिव हाई पास फिल्टर्स, पैसिव बैंड पास फिल्टर्स एंड पैसिव बैंड स्टॉप फिल्टर्स, दीज फोर। सो टोटल 8 फिल्टर्स कैन बी स्टडीड। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू गो थ्रू पैसिव फिल्टर्स ओनली। सो वील गो थ्रू 4 पैसिव फिल्टर्स वन बाय वन, लो पास, हाई पास, बैंड पास एंड बैंड स्टॉप। बैंड स्टॉप फिल्टर इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज अ बैंड रिजेक्ट फिल्टर और नॉच फिल्टर्स ऑल्सो। सो दिस वॉज रिगार्डिंग द डिफरेंट टाइप्स। सो वी विल बी मूविंग थ्रू वन ईच टाइप इन डिटेल फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। सो RC लो पास फिल्टर, इट इज नथिंग बट पैसिव लो पास फिल्टर, अगेन RC, बिकॉज वी आर गोइंग टू यूज ओनली रेजिस्टर्स एंड कैपेसिटर्स फॉर द कंस्ट्रक्शन। सो इट कैन ऑल्सो बी कॉल्ड एज RC लो पास फिल्टर। सो अ लो पास फिल्टर LPF इज अ फिल्टर दैट पासेस सिग्नल विद अ फ्रीक्वेंसी लोअर दैन अ सिलेक्टेड कट ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड अटेन्यूएट्स, दैट मीन्स रिजेक्ट्स सिग्नल्स विद फ्रीक्वेंसीज हायर दैन द कट ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी। सो हियर वी कैन सी अ स्मॉल सर्किट इन विच वी आर हैविंग टू components, one is a resistor with value R and the capacitor with value C. Current is flowing, the current I is flowing through the circuit. So there is some AC voltage is given as an input to this filter, and that is Vin, and we are getting here some output voltage V out. So how this works? So definitely at the input there are signals with this Vin will be having different frequencies, signals will be coming. So basically how this works, for that we need to go for these two formula here. So this XC is nothing but it is the reactance of the capacitor, and reactance, we know reactance is the opposition of a circuit element. Here the capacitor is the element, opposition of a circuit element to the flow of current due to the element's capacitance. Rather here it is a capacitor, so reactance will be the resistance opposition, that means resistance offered by this capacitor due to its capacitance. So for the capacitors, we can say greater the reactance, it leads to the smaller currents for the same voltage applied. Okay, so whatever the voltage is applied, as the reactance is more, the current passing through the circuit will be less. Okay, so again the reactance can be calculated by this formula here, that is it is inversely proportional to the frequency and the capacitance of the capacitor. Okay, so as frequency increases, definitely capacitive reactance is going to decrease. As we can see here, it is the inversely proportional thing. So XC is 1 upon omega C. Again omega, we can, this omega is expressed in radians per second. Again if you want to express it in terms of hertz, that is frequency f in hertz, we can say omega is equal to 2 pi f. So we can convert that formula to 1 upon 2 pi fc. So xc is 1 upon 2 pi fc, where f is measured in hertz and c is in farads. Okay, so basically if the frequencies which are passing through this circuit will be very high, then the reactance offered will be very low. Okay, so if the reactance offered will be low, see here it is a low pass filter. So when we are going to pass some voltage through this circuit, it may be having different frequency signals. So at very low frequencies, see here, if the frequencies will be low, the reactance will be very high. So at the low frequencies, what is going to happen? The reactance offered by this capacitor will be high by this formula. Okay, So when if the reactance offered by this capacitor will be high, that means it will oppose the flow of current through this path. So whatever the signal is coming at this point will be going at the output side. Okay. So at low frequencies, the current will pass towards the output side. It won't pass through this path as this capacitor will offer higher reactance or higher opposition for the flow of current. As we know, greater reactance leads to smaller current. So very small current will be flowing through this capacitor. So basically, we'll get an output here. At very low frequencies, all V in will be sent to V out directly. As the frequencies are going to increase, what's going to happen? At higher frequencies, the reactance offered will become less. By using this formula, we can get that at higher frequencies, the reactance offered will be less. So the opposition offered by the capacitor will be less, and because of that, the circuit becomes short-circuited here, and all the input will be passing through this capacitor to this ground. So there will not be any output at very high frequencies. So basically, the low-pass filter will work like this, and the values of R and C will decide the frequency, which is called as a cutoff frequency, right? What is the cutoff frequency? The cutoff frequency is nothing but beyond that frequency, all the frequency signals will be rejected by this filter. So that frequency is decided by the values of R and C here. This is the second formula. FC is nothing but cutoff frequency, which is again 1 divided by 2 pi RC. And this R and C, that is the resistor R, value of resistor R in ohms, and the value of capacitance in farad, that will give us the frequency in hertz. Okay. So whatever the cutoff frequency, that can be calculated, or while designing the filter, we have to choose the values of resistor and capacitor in such a way that we can get the required cutoff frequency f. And beyond this frequency, all the frequencies will be rejected by this low pass filter. So basically, I think you have got cleared regarding low pass filter, how it's going to work. At very low frequencies, the capacitor won't allow any current to flow. So whatever the input voltage, input signal will be sent, it will be directly going to V out. So V out will be V in at that time. At very high frequencies, the reactance is going to increase, the current flow will be, sorry, reactance will be going to decrease, and the current will be flowing through the short circuit. So V out will be zero. So this was regarding low pass filter. Again, we have already gone through the frequency response graph in short, but here it is in detail. So we can see here, this is a graph of frequency in hertz with the amplitude. So output is nothing but we can say amplitude here. So at low values, see here, at low values it's going to pass. And at the higher frequency values, beyond this FC, we have seen it is the cutoff frequency. Beyond the cutoff frequency, the output is going to get decreased. So for a certain value up to FC, the filter is going to pass the output, or rather the input to the output. So it is called as a pass band. So from 0 to FC is the pass band. Which is the band of low frequencies. It is called as a bandwidth. And beyond this FC, as the frequency increases, the output decreases with 20 decibel per decade is the slope of this line. So it is the value of decrease of the output, 20 dB per decade means for every 20 dB per decade. Okay, so actually FC is nothing but it is the actually value that is 70%, 70% of the input value. So output will be 70% of the input value at this FC, and then beyond that it is going to decrease towards the zero. So beyond FC it will be a stop band. Beyond FC there will not be any signal, or rather higher frequency signal is rejected beyond FC. So this is the frequency response curve for low pass filter. Then next is RC high pass filter. A high pass filter HPF is an electronic filter that passes signals with a frequency higher than a certain cutoff frequency and attenuates or rejects signals with frequencies lower than the cutoff frequency. Again, here working will be the same, only the difference we can see here is what is done in comparison with the low pass filter is the positions of the components are interchanged. So resistor is interchanged with the capacitor, the places are interchanged. So here capacitor is in series with the output and resistor is in parallel connection with the output. Same formula we are going to go through. So there will be some certain cutoff frequency based on the values of capacitor and resistor will be decided, and beyond that frequency all the signals will be passed to the output, and for the signals lower than this cutoff frequency there will not be any output, as again reactance of this capacitor will come into picture. At we know at low frequencies the reactance will be higher. At low frequencies value of omega, it is very less, then the X will be more as it is inversely proportional ratio. So at high reactance the current will not pass through this capacitor as good as it is an open circuit. Okay, so at very low frequencies input won't be passed towards the output as this capacitor is going to act as an open circuit. There will not be any flow of current at low frequencies as the reactance will be high, and at very high frequencies the reactance offered will be very less, so opposition will be less and the output can be imagined as an input, it will be sent to output. So this is regarding the working of a high pass filter. So here again we can go for the frequency response curve. See, it is exactly opposite of the low pass filter. Again here for high pass filter this is the frequency, cutoff frequency, and the stop band, that is all the low frequencies will be stopped up to FC, and beyond FC all the frequencies will be passed to the output. So again the same is the case, the slope, that is 20 dB per decade. So as the frequency is going to increase the output is going to increase with the slope of 20 dB per decade, right? And the FC is the cutoff frequency where we can get the output which is 70% of the input, and from that as the frequency is going to get increased the output is again going to get increased and it will be 100% of the input at par. This is the pass band of the frequency. So this is the frequency response for the RC high pass filter. So next is the RC band pass filter. So here the band pass filter, that is BPF, is a device that passes frequencies within a certain range and rejects or attenuates the frequencies outside that range. So basically what we need here is band pass filter is, it will allow a certain band of frequencies to pass and it will reject all the other frequency signals less than the some cutoff frequency FC1 we can call, and greater than some cutoff frequency FC2. So as we can see here the circuit diagram, it is again we can see here that this is The first side of this circuit again is a combination of a capacitor and a resistor. We can call it as a high pass filter. See here, this is high pass filter and here it is a low pass filter. So it is the combination of high pass filter and low pass filter. High pass filter is connected in series with the low pass filter here in this circuit. So we'll see the frequency response. So here some certain low cutoff frequency, here it is a cutoff frequency FC1 and FC2, we can see here. Here it is FC shown, both are not FC, here it is FC1, here it is FC2. So this is the lower frequency FCL, we can see here, lower cutoff frequency, and FCH, that is higher cutoff frequency. So we are having two frequencies. So as there is a combination of two filters, that is high pass filter and low pass filter, both the filters will be having their own cutoff frequencies. So this is the cutoff frequency of a low pass filter and this is the cutoff frequency of a high pass filter. So high pass filter will pass all the frequencies signals greater than this FL first, and then those all signals will be again sent to a low pass filter where some frequency cutoff will be there for higher frequencies, that is FH. So it will reject all the frequencies beyond that frequency. So only this bandwidth, that is FH minus FL, whatever the value will be there, FH minus FL, that bandwidth will be the range of frequencies that will be passed through this band pass filter. So it is an RC band pass filter that is using only resistors and capacitors. So by construction we can see that it is the combination of a RC high pass filter and a RC low pass filter. By using the combination we can reject the frequencies lower than the FL and the frequencies higher than the FH. So only this band will be available at the output, certain band. Okay. So this was regarding band pass filter. Next, RC band stop filter. It is also called as a band reject filter or a notch filter. In signal processing, a band stop filter or a band rejection filter is a filter that passes most frequencies unaltered but attenuates those, or attenuates, rejects those in a specific range. Okay. So again, this is the combination circuit. We can see here again, here only the difference is low pass filter is used first and then high pass filter. The frequency response curve will look like this. So it will reject the frequencies in between FL and FH. So all the other frequencies will be allowed to pass here. Only the additional thing is we have to use an adder circuit in combination with this circuit. So we need an adder circuit, so it will add the output of low pass as well as a high pass filter and it will send to the output, but it will reject this bandwidth here, which is called the stop band, from FL to FH. So all the frequencies available in between these two will be rejected, and frequencies below this FL will be allowed to pass to output, and frequencies beyond this FH will be again allowed to pass to output. This is regarding the band stop filter. Okay, here for just getting an idea how this all going to happen, we are having an original signal here which is very complex, a number of different frequency signals are combined together. So we can see here component frequencies, this is one kind of frequency which is having this signal is having low frequency, this is the medium frequency signal, and this is high frequency signal. So all these frequencies are combined in this original signal. So we can see here it is having a very different kind of shape. So here all the four filters are available. First is low pass filter, then high pass filter, then band pass filter and notch filter, or we can say band stop filter. So we are going to give this input signal to all the four filters, and we are going to observe what is the output. So when we are going to give this original signal to low pass filter, it will only allow the low frequency signal at an output. So this is the low frequency signal which we can get here, and the response will be like this. Only low frequencies will be allowed, and the frequencies beyond cutoff frequencies will be rejected. Then high pass filter, only high frequency signals are allowed at output, and the low frequency signals are rejected below the cutoff frequency fc. In band pass filter, only the band of frequencies will be allowed. So very low frequencies are also rejected, and very high frequencies are also rejected. So low frequencies as well as high frequencies are rejected. Only the middle range, that is the bandwidth, will be allowed as an output here. So we can see here the signal. And in notch filter, only certain middle range frequencies are rejected. All other, that is low frequency signals and high frequency signal, both are passed through the notch filter. So lower range frequencies are allowed, certain band is rejected, and again higher range is allowed. So the certain band, that is middle band, is rejected here. We can see here low frequencies and higher frequency signals are passed to the output. So this is a small graphical representation how all, or rather we can say comparison of different filters, how all the filters are going to work. So this was regarding the RC filters or passive filters. In next video, we are going to go through the active filters. Thank you.